Gene therapy is a promising approach for treating retinal degeneration based on animal models. Last May, 3-year results in patients treated with gene therapy demonstrated that therapeutic interventions can improve function but is not able to slow the natural history of the disease. As a means to explain these results, it was suggested that diseased retina had reached a point of no return, that is, too late or insufficient transduction, that is, too little. To determine the therapeutic window for rescue, we are addressing this point of no return hypothesis. That is, patients are already not treatable at the time that diagnosis was made by an eye care professional. Therefore, therapeutic interventions must be able to demonstrate efficacy in retinas with mid and late phase diseases. In our Journal of Clinical Investigation report, we applied a novel inducible therapeutic activation using site-specific recombination in embryonic stem cell strategies. We show a fundus picture of a phosphodiesterase deficient patient, which is the model that we're using for this study. Phosphodiesterase deficiency are responsible for about 72,000 cases of retinitis pigmentosa worldwide.
We generated a mouse model of retinitis pigmentosa in which the mutant rod-specific PDE6 beta gene leads to the degeneration of rods followed by the death of cones. The importance of the model is that it allowed us to restore the mutant gene in all rod photoreceptors at any time point of disease progression. Thereby, we were able to generate an optimally treated retina at early, mid, or late disease stages and then analyze the rescue effects. We showed that at all three treatment time points, vision was rescued and photoreceptor cell death halted. In untreated mutant mice, the outer nuclear layer decreased over time, reflecting progressive degeneration of photoreceptors, which were entirely gone by 1 year. After treatment at mid or late disease stages, any further decrease in outer nuclear layer was prevented. Earlier treatment was associated with greater rescue because cell death was still modest. However, even late-stage treatment directly prevented further rod degeneration and indirectly prevented cone degeneration as well. We showed that these rescue effects were stable and long-lasting over the 1-year study. These data demonstrate a broad time window for gene therapy and suggest that retinitis pigmentosa patients are treatable even after dramatic degeneration has occurred.